What is going on, guys? DBG here, and today we are going to be going over some of the squads for the, well, the Irate Your Team series in NBA 2K22 My Team. Normally I would say go follow me on Twitter, but honestly, I don't plan on tweeting anything. Like, I don't, anytime soon, like, again, a couple of tweets here and there. I don't have the app. I literally don't have the app on my phone. I literally still have it online, obviously, for this video and for messages. Obviously, said something about my birthday and then decided just play a draft and made a layup. And then, obviously, for this video, I need it. But other than that, look, follow me if you want. Don't if you don't. I'm not going to be using it much from now on. But, yeah, so. Anyway. Let's look at the team. Current gen, Hawks 2018. Run lots of pick and roll, pick and drive and kick. Only have 10 KMT. Spent all things in Ellis. Duncan and Miles are juiced up. Looking to replace Harper. Okay. Hey, let me take a look at this team. So. Boone, Ellis, Carr, Gus, Eaton. If Eaton's getting destroyed, you got Saric off the bench. Okay, I like that. I like that. Okay, Harper. I think who's good to replace Harper. Honestly, if I'm replacing Harper, I'm going, because of the way your starting lineup is, I'm playing like a De'Aaron Fox. If you can get him for like 20k, I'm just getting by like a De'Aaron Fox or a Stephon Marbury, then bring Boone to the bench. Because Boone can guard ball, but on your starters, ML Carr can guard ball, also Gus Gerard can guard ball. So putting ML Carr on ball and starting like a Marbury, a more offensive player in your starting line, is probably the best thing you can do. But this is not a bad team. Like a 6 out of 10. Or not a 6 out of 10. Like a 7.5 out of 10. Around 200k on current gen. So my face is currently covering a Kyrie Irving. So this team right here. I mean, Blake's pretty good. Brad's a weird player to pick. Kelly's okay. I mean, Kyrie versus D. Brown, I think, is quite close. Griffith, I like Griffith. I think Griffith's better than Guerin or Grant. If Jamal Murray can play a 2, I'd play Jamal at the 2 and play Boone at the 1. Jamal's taller. And other than that, the team doesn't have too much height. Like, the bench lineup isn't going to play much defense, but I mean, not a bad team by any means, so I'll go, like, again, 7.5 out of 10. I got 7.5 out of 10 for these guys. Not bad. Not great either. Okay. 250k to work with. Mainly holding on to MT for a guy like Steph before the first quals. I doubt Steph's going to come out before first quals. About to finish getting Wilt. People sleep on Otis with that goal, quick first step, and quick dribble stop. I mean, if he works for you, he works for you. My only problem is he's 6'3 and can't play the 1. But defensively... we've got Wade Van Vliet who play defense, Glenn who plays defense, LeBron who plays defense. Cat's a bit of a weird one. Like, you have so much MT and you got Cat. But again, Cat's good, great on offense. He just doesn't really play much on defense. Apologies if I'm covering my eyes. I don't know what it is. It's just the glare of the screen is really affecting me today. It sometimes happens like that. I just need to find, and I can't find my blue light glasses. Just take a little bit off. I don't know what is going on. But yeah, so they're not bad players at all. Like, your team is deep. And then you've got Wolf Frazier there for to come off, either come off the bench or start if you need more of a defender. I like this team. This is by far the best team. I mean, it's a little bit lacking in terms of the interior presence, so I'm going to give it like an 8.5, but like, this is an 8. This is a legit 8.5 out of 10. This is a legit 8.5 out of 10. This is not a bad squad at all. And again, dude's going for Wilt, so like, he obviously is a good player. Because I'm like, this is an all-out offense team, though. Like, you're going to be good defending the perimeter, not going to be good defending inside. Like, if you come up against a Shaq or a Wilt, you're going to struggle. Okay, so I think this team is just another solid team. Okay, I'm looking to see a team that maybe you can, there can be some change made. Okay, this team's interesting. So no money spent, 21 delay. Okay, my face is currently covering Goatmere, Godson, and LaMelo Ball. And Sam Jones, the 3, doesn't work because he's 6'3". Okay, so you got 31k. I don't mind Blake. I just wouldn't play Blake with Dre. And I also wouldn't play Blake and Miles Bridges. Your height's a bit of a problem in this team. Like, your second tallest player. Or your third tallest player in your entire roster is, like, TJ Warren. You got two players in your entire team that are above 6'8". And, like, I don't mind Draymond. But Draymond's not going to play the greatest. He's not going to give you any interior presence. And neither is Blake, so you're going to struggle with that. I don't mind Trae Young, and I don't mind Jameer Nelson. I don't mind LeVert. I think maybe, can you put the LeVert money into somewhere better? Who I run a point guard? Yeah, it's hard to find that cheap, really good cheap point guard, isn't it? It is hard to find that player. So, I'm going to give this team at this stage, it's like a 7 out of 10, it really is. But I'm going to, yeah, I'm going to leave it at that. I go 7 out of 10. And apologies for no face cam for the rest of this video. I'm currently looking at my screen. I'm constantly looking up and down on my screen. So there's no point if most of my time you're just looking at the top of my head. Because I'm not facing the screen most of the time. But yeah, now we have got... Here's 100k in your binders. Not looking to spend it all. Yeah, yeah. Caris LeVert is probably... He's not the first player. I would look to upgrade these point guards first. I don't mind your point guards, but that would definitely be my... my first, like, action for this team would be to go for the... would be to go for point guards more than anything. So, Hawks 2018. This is just another decent squad. Okay, I'm trying to find an interesting squad here. Like, if I'm skipping your squad's fine. Like, if anyone is looking for me to rate their squad, like, your squad is fine. It's somewhere between, like, a 7 and an 8.5 if I'm skipping your squad. Does every single player that play this game have the exact same squad right now? And I get it, yeah, there's some changes. But, like, it's some variation of, like, Kyrie, Dame, Fred VanVleet, Anthony Simons, and... I don't know. Well, that's the first times you've seen. And sometimes a starter card. My God, is there anyone who has a little bit of a different squad? Glenn, Token Rewards, Gus, ML Carr, Draymond in every team. For God's sake, they're all the same team. Like, these are all the same. I don't care. Like, this team and this team. Yeah, I get it. Cat's not... Cat and Pet are two different players. You know what? I get it. I get it because they technically are two different players. Like, Cat and Thing definitely are technically two different players. But, like, every team has Ibaka. Every team has a shooting center. Every team has Gus. Nearly every team has Glenn. Nearly every team has either Griffith or a Token Reward. And if you can't afford them, maybe a Duncan Robinson. Can I just find... Okay, this team's a little bit different. This team's different. Okay, perfect. So Kyrie and Boone, I like that. De'Aaron at the two-headed monster. You've got two small shooting guards. That's very interesting. Like, Ibaka is your backup center, I assume. And then Thing is a big body in case needed. Gobert. Duncan Robinson is an interesting team. This is an interesting team because, like, I think your MT could be spent better than LeBron. I think that, like, 150k is just not worth it. I think that 150k, honestly, is just really not worth that. Not worth picking up, so... I like Kawhi. I love Kawhi. Beal's good. Ibaka's a good big man. Then Gobert's not a bad big body. Julius Erving's really good as a small forward. And then if you want more of an offensive punch, you've got Duncan Robinson. This is like an 8. It's still like an 8, but it's something different. Okay. Why did you send me a freaking vertical image? Let's try to look at it from here, because this is an interesting team. Channing Frye, Boucher is your bigs. You're going to struggle big time for speed. Then at the 4, you've got Spencer Haywood, who's actually a very, very fast center. But not very fast at the power forward position. Or not very fast at the power forward. You're starting Ibaka at the 4. Clear speed, you must play at the slow at a snail's pace because otherwise these guys are going to struggle on both ends of the floor. TJ Warren, Kyrie, Jamal Murray, and off the bench you've got Kemba, who's like poor man's Kyrie. You've got Michael Cooper. Man, how did you get, do you have enough MT for Michael Cooper? Man, you must have spent a lot of MT on this. You must have a lot of MT just tied up. Jamal Mashburn? And I know you guys can't see the squad probably on video, but this is an actual interesting team. I mean, it's like a 6 out of 10, but everyone can kind of shoot. It's like a 6 out of 10 at best, but it's just, it's different. It's different. Another of the same team all over again. Mostly play for fun. Okay. All right. Peja Stojakovic does not belong, not only in somebody's team, unless you are the biggest Peja fan. If you're a Kings fan, if you're from Serbia, as far as I'm aware, he's Serbian. If I'm wrong, I do apologize. Unless you are the biggest Peja Stojakovic fan ever, what is Peja Stojakovic doing? What is Peja Stojakovic doing anywhere near your team? The guy can't do anything. The guy's a shooter that can't shoot. Let's be clear about that. The guy is a shooter that can't shoot. So, for me, that just screams useless. Peja Stojakovic is like poor man's Duncan Robinson, but costs 3 times as much, or 4 times as much. You got no shooting in your bench center in Rudy Gobert, which can be a problem. I don't mind using Rudy Gobert, but you always need a shooter at the end. Even putting a Bargnani in as a gold kind of will help with that. Because you have just basically said when your bench lineup is in the game that someone can paint sit on you. And yes, Rudy Gobert is a good player. I'm not saying to get rid of Rudy Gobert. I'm definitely just saying to buy a shooting center and throw him on the end of your bench. Because even though it will cost a little bit of extra MT, that is worth it. Even if it is, for example, an Andrea Bargnani. Like, you're paying only an extra, like, 30 MT a game to get, like, Boucher in there. And that's just, that could be the difference between win and losing a game. Okay. 55 tokens away from first pink diamond, half of the koozie. Or long-term plays Westfall. Okay. So, Fred, Richie, Griffith, Green. You got Westfall as your backup two guard. Trying to think for Westfall who to come in at this stage in the game that's cheap. I do like Westfall, and you have Griffith. What I would do is I'd just buy Darius Miles. I'd move Griffith to your, because Griffith's, I think, too small for a small forward. I'd just move either Garen or Griffith, whichever player you prefer. I would move to the backup two guard, and I would start Darius Miles, and then you're good. That's how you replace Westfall without losing MT. Because if you like Worthy, you're definitely gonna like Darius Miles. Darius Miles is way better than James Worthy, and then you got Boucher there end of the bench anyway to help you if Gobert is struggling. I like this team again. This is like a solid 7.5. Okay, this is a squad right here. You got 200k. Obviously, don't spend that yet. But Mutombo, that's the first Mutombo we've seen. It's the first Mutombo, Wilt, or Shaq. Again, this is just like the generic team with Mutombo. Let's go 8.5 out of 10. Luka? Really? He's using Luka. That is a surprise. Can't lie. That is a surprise. You don't see many Lukas out in these streets. But, generic team with Luka. Not a bad team. I'll go like 7 out of 10. Or 7.5. Or no, I'll go 8 out of 10. 8 out of 10. But like, a lot of people are telling me, oh, we need suggestions. First of all, there's not a lot of great players to buy. And I can't even say a tactical downgrade, because most people's teams are just reward cards. Can we just... Okay. Like, I'm not going to be too long in this video, because again, I'm kind of struggling today. But Darren Williams is sixth man. Okay. This is a very, very weird. Who? Why? Dude, if you're watching this video, why are you using MTDB? Just use 2KDB like the rest of us. Use 2KDB like the rest of the sane people. Because MTDB has not been relevant since, well, it was only relevant in that like 3 month spell where 2K MT Central was just late on cards and before 2KDB. But this team's insane. You're a little bit short, but you have this lineup and but you still have TJ Warren in the team. I'm sorry, but I personally think Siakam's better than TJ Warren. I would also be tempted to say Dr. J or Ray Allen in over Sleepy. I know you locked in for Sleepy, but I don't rate him that highly. Other than that, though, I like your team. So I'm going to say, like, look, you got Shaq and Brad and stuff, so I'll give it a 9. Okay. Okay, Iverson at the... This is a weird team. So, dude's got Sleepy Floyd there at the one that you guys can't see on screen. Like, he's obviously got... He obviously plays the game if he's got Wilt. Larry, holographic Dikembe, holographic Iverson at the two. I would personally not run Iverson at the two, honestly. I would run Iverson as your bench point guard, or Iverson as your starting point guard. Or even flip Iverson D-Rose, that works as well. Granger. I mean, Jerry Lucas is like, there's like one player is an imposter. Find the imposter. Like, the imposter is clearly, you've got the three-headed monster of centers. Like, who is the imposter? Most definitely, we can all see who the imposter is right now. Like, honestly, just get yourself a freaking Darius Miles and play him at the four. Get yourself a worthy. Trying to think who else you can get yourself. Like, I made an entire video yesterday going over power forwards. Get yourself any of those guys. Other than that, like, you've got all the best players in the game. So it's like a... I'll give it like a 9.4, 9.5 out of 10. But just replace the Jerry Lucas with somebody better. And your team's going to be basically perfect. Okay. We're going to go over one more squad right here. I just need to find a unique one. This is not unique at all. This is a BPL team. Is Ivan Toney's god? Why are you using... Why the hell would you use... Okay, you obviously have an untradeable Messi in there. Why the hell would you use Jordan Henderson? When you can just, like... That's even worse than using Calvin Phillips. When you can just put Ivan Toney there. Like, you just put Ivan Toney there. And you can play... Ndombele, Musa, Sissoko. Onyeka. You can play anyone there. What are you doing, man? What are you doing? And instead of playing, like... And then flip Stones to there and play Wan-Bissaka or Fredericks. What are you doing, man? Okay, so. One more unique team. I've seen a lot of Anthony Simons by scrolling. Okay. Okay, this might be a unique team. Drive and kicks, post up big men, got Ibaka, 120k. Okay, if you've got Ibaka, get Ibaka in that team quickly. Like, you've got Boucher playing power forward, you've got Kelly Oubre. Okay, this is a teardown job. And I get it, you don't want to spend a bunch of empty. So hear me out. Keep Duncan Robinson, keep Andrew Wiggins. I don't, like, again, if you're just playing offline, Patty Mills is fine. If you're trying to play offline, you're going to be eaten alive. Get yourself, like, a Goatmere. Or even a Mike Conley. If you don't want to spend your MT, get yourself a freaking Mike Conley. Goatmere works as well for, like, defensive purposes. Or if you want to play offense, go Dame Lillard and throw Wiggins on ball. Gus Gerard, pretty good card. Mitchell Robinson, I mean, Mitchell Robinson's a big body. One of those last three spots has to be a center. You should not have Collison and John Barry. They're 2 point guards. One of them has to be a center, and I would advise Rick Smith because he's like 4K MT and he's a giant. If you've got a backup, put him in the team. And then instead of Kelly Oubre, just spend like your 3K MT on a even 3K. Spend your 1K MT on like a Jalen Green. That helps out a lot. So yeah, that is pretty much it. That is all we've got time for today. Like, I'm really not feeling the best. I haven't been feeling well for a few days. My head's just been all over the place. I don't know. Honestly, don't know what is wrong with me. But I should be fine. I'm just going to go practice now. I should be feeling okay later today to go over like the news videos. And then we're getting ready for content tomorrow. So yeah, that is pretty much it. That is the video. Let me know if you... next time I will tweet this out again. That may be the next tweet I make, honestly, a week this day next week or Wednesday next week. Either way, it is what it is. Thank you guys for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe.